Alright, welcome back. Time to battle some more. Alright. This hand is pretty decent, I would say. Like, on the draw. I mean, it's a little power light, but we are on the draw. So it's alright, I think. Especially because if we find one power, we have a Dune Phantom that stabilizes us a lot, and we have Polymorph for problem cards. I guess we had Polymorph. Also guys, please apologize if I'm a bit like down low and like on the more quiet and low energy side between like the last recording and like recording the first three games and this one during the editing. I suddenly started feeling quite sickly and feverish, so I'm really not doing too well right now, and I'm just trying to like pull through this recording, finish it, get it online for you guys, and then just lie in bed. Not sure where this is coming from. I haven't even been outside much in the last week or so, where it's like cold or anything, and have mostly been like chilling at home because I have like semester holidays and hadn't been like really in contact with people, so not sure where I'm like getting sick from, but I'm definitely feeling pretty sick right now and feel exactly the way you do once you like start getting a fever and like a cold or flu or something, and it sucks. Alright, we did not manage to get there, which sucks a bit, but alright. I guess we just sort of attack here with our stranger, because this guy can hold the fort. Opponent keeps drawing cards. That's not bad. Definitely wouldn't mind drawing some cards. Like, what is going on with our opponents today? Like, we are fucking power screwed, and he is doing just fine and drawing like tons of extra cards, and he's scooping. Like, what the hell? I mean, I take it, but it's a bit like sad and stupid for the videos, so sorry guys. Next game. Next chance. Clear redraw on one power. This is better. Still one power short, but at least if we find the third, we also get the force for Kami Guardian. And also likely the fixing for Guardian and Polymorph. Alright. Let's hope this works out better than the last two power hand. Then again, the last two power hand won because our opponent conceded, so didn't do too bad after all. Just didn't do too well in drawing the third power by turn three segment. But who cares if you win? This is annoying, but at least we have Polymorph to stop it, or just like Dune Phantom, so it's not that big of a deal. Alright. This is decent. But I think I'll stick to Dune Phantom first, and then we'll deploy from there on once the pressure is relieved. Let's hope he doesn't have like a rapid shot, that would be annoying. Or like, I don't know, Lightning Storm or something, if he wants to blow that here. Which he might, because Dune Phantom is pretty annoying. Even more so if he has a Serpent Trainer. Alright, so I think the best plan actually probably is just playing Karmic Guardian to have like enough ways to stop the Serpent Trainer and make sure that we don't get Serpent Trainer. And I mean, here if he Lightning Storms, it's still like a 2-2 trade, so it's fine. Alright, no more attacks. That's cool. Alright, so I think kind of what I do here is this and this. Get some stuff on the board. Probably not attack, he might have like a lightning strike. No need to run into that right now. Maybe if he like uses up his power, taps out, we can just predator strike something. I guess like play this guy, get a power, polymorph this guy and get in with those two and see if he has a lightning strike. I mean, it's fine if he does. Could have also just only attacked with the Lucent Stranger, but I'm like not too concerned with losing the Determined Stranger to a lightning strike. Just don't want to attack with the Karmic Guardian just to gain one life and potentially lose it to like this. That is interesting to say the least, and I guess sort of forces us to Harsh Rule, which is annoying. Guess we just like, no, we don't attack. I think we can just like try and bait something more out of it. Maybe we get something. It's not that likely if he isn't stupid, but there's always a chance. We've seen stupider stuff before. I mean, I'm just gonna do like the heads up play. I don't wanna take seven here and just see where this goes. And we got something more. Nice. And a really good one, a card that would have easily beaten us post-Harsh Rule. And I think we can safely wait another turn. Trick him a bit with emoticons, showing him that we are not happy about what he's doing to us. I think I'm gonna take 7 and just jump a shower. Oh yeah, now we have like even a legitimate reason to block this way. See if he's gonna like drop something else. People at this level might. Nope, he doesn't. But that's cool. I mean, we get in for 1 and then blow up the board. And now Karmic Guardian with Hammer of Might and Predator's Instincts might do a pretty good job at taking over the game against whatever he has left. It's a pretty powerful follow-up, especially if he doesn't have any follow-up to the Harsh Rule. So, hammer in the morning, hammer in the evening. Hammer all day. There we go. Get back all that juicy life we lost. And yeah, Predator's Instinct on 4/7 Karmic Guardian. It's nothing to sneeze at. That's disappointing, but not much we can do about it. And it's still okay. I mean, we have a fatty to draw from the hammer trigger to use Instinct with later, so that's fine. And I guess more Instinct to use once we get there, as long as he doesn't do anything. Pinging for 1 and war crying is a decent start. Ooh, there we go. Sexy beast. Let's hope he doesn't have a removal for that, and that should do the trick. I mean, I guess we could have like instincted the beast and attacked. That would have probably actually been correct, given that we have 2. Yeah, I guess. I guess that would have been a reasonable plan. Interesting. No block. I mean, it's not like the block is good for him, but I was thinking he might have like a block plus something. But he doesn't seem to, so game is over right here and right now. Most likely. Alright, in we go. That's annoying, but not a big deal. just buys him some time. But having to waste cards to do that is good for us. Gets us indirectly also closer to victory. Yes, we just kill this guy to get a Warcry trigger for whatever reason. Feeling so jittery. Sucks. Why couldn't that wait until I finished this draft? I've really appreciated this. Alright, one more. And then the last part of the series in the last video. Alright, that's a solid hand. Gonna keep this. Not much going on. We're up against Elysian. He's still not doing anything, so get that stranger out there rather than play for our harsh rule. For now at least. Alright. This guy is annoying. But we can potentially Predator's Instinct it. I think sort of wanna Ancient Lore first. Take 5 and then see what we do next turn. Just a lot more tempo efficient, and I think taking 5 there is okay. And maybe he plays like another good card that we need to deal with, and then we just have a solid harsh rule. That does not warrant a harsh rule yet. And I guess gonna just shut this down. That's all right. Given that we have a Desert Marshal. I think I want to use the Stranger here rather than the Marshal, thanks to the safer turn in hand. I mean, it's a bit worse against the 2-1, but overall it gives us much more flexibility. I think at this point we are sort of playing for harsh rule value in a not too obvious fashion. Gonna get hit for like 2 by the Acolyte and stuff for a while, and then pull the trigger on harsh rule. That's cool. Go ahead. Oh, so I guess Fate doesn't get revealed anymore, because if I'm not mistaken, his hurler didn't get revealed, so it just looks basically the same as Echo, so you don't know whether it is Fate or Echo. Interesting. I guess I'm gonna take 6 here. And I hope he does play something else and then we harsh rule. Plus he even might not deal us 6 exactly, because the Marshal is a 4-3. And we got another unit. The art of baiting with harsh rule. Boom. Something that our hand definitely needed, given how flooded we are. Well, I mean, he has a lot of power too, but he drew like more powerful cards on average, I guess. Alright, get those flyers out there to race. I guess we can like Desert Marshal, or like actually Karmic Guardian, Desert Marshal, the Terrazon. That's annoying. But yeah, we're just gonna try to race, sort of. more Echo of Fate. So this is annoying because it means we have to sort of like trade all three. But I guess that's the world we live in now. And I hope he doesn't have a way to blow us out. I mean, we still trade like 2.5 for like 2 cards or something. It's not terrible, but it's not great. Especially because we probably have slightly less resources than our opponent. But he didn't drop anything, so he doesn't seem to have much either. Alright, the beatdown continues. No opponent seems to be holding a bunch of power. I'm gonna block. That was a bit ambitious, I guess, but we'll see. Nah, that was the like nice play, I guess. Annoying. I mean, it was a weird attack, but I just didn't expect this. Maybe I should have expected it, not sure. I mean, at that level, I just don't give people enough credit, I guess, to respect this attack. And this helps with the stabilizing. A lot, actually. Yeah, we definitely have to trade here. This is really bad for us. Gonna put it on this because it gives us 2 like good blockers rather than putting it on here and only giving us 1 good blocker. But yeah, we're gonna get beat down by the Xenon Guardian if we don't draw like Polymorph. We might be losing here. Seems fairly likely that we are. I think Polymorph is like the only thing we can draw here. I guess like a Terrazon or something, or like Lumen Defender to have like a decent gang block would also help. Yeah, no, that doesn't help anymore. There's the Shepherd. I meant Shepherd, not Defender. But yeah, this is too little too late. Because Dinomancer is a freaking bomb that is super hard to beat. So nasty. All right. Triple block it is. Actually, I think this is a better triple block. Because then we only lose those 2 rather than those 2. I mean, actually not, we lose those 2. Yeah, both blocks are kind of bad, but yeah. I guess we should have blocked the other way around now that I think about it, because the 4-6 at least stops like Carnosaurus for a while. But yeah, this game is over, we are dead. Dinomancer into a 9-9 conduit after a Xenon Defender is definitely too much to take. Our deck. Anyways. Alright. That's it for the second part of the games. See you in a moment with the last part of the games. Stay tuned.